around 2015, I got a call from Uber, and Uber was basically, this is the situation they were in. They were like, hey, we've got all of this unique data, right? Like nobody else has this data about like people's locations like this, and travel and cars and cities and drivers and riders and stuff like that. And so we have more data than anybody else about this thing. And we're currently in the spot where we're just trying to like figure out like literally like how to store it all. Like they were kind of in the very early days of just getting their data stuff together. They were building the first data team, but they're thinking about like, we've got a lot of data scientists here. We know we can do a lot of cool stuff with this data. What can we do to impact our users with this data? We know how to use this data to do analyses and find patterns, and we've done a lot of stuff successfully with that, kind of like internal investigations, kind of internal and analyses for internal stakeholders. But how do we kind of activate this data to allow us to have a better product for our customers, to build new products, to drive our systems with data-driven automated decisioning, right? So you want to do that. You can't have a human in the loop, and it's at a scale where also it's like a speed and a scale. It doesn't make sense for a human, and that's basically perfectly what machine learning's for. So the idea was like, how do we enable machine learning at Uber? How do we make machine learning possible? And so they said, hey, can you come help us do that? So I joined, and there was a team of like maybe five-ish people. It was me and a couple of engineers, and so I was the product manager, and we were like the machine learning team, and our task was to, you know, democratize machine learning at Uber. And
And how if I may, so it sounds like you join Uber to build, to lead their ML, like today we those teams are called ML platform teams very often. Your paper, right? Uber's machine learning platform. It sounds like you've been a leader of one of the first ML platform teams, if not at Google, at Uber at least. But when I was reading, it is how I met you, like via paper. I read the paper. It is when I first heard about you. But it is 2 years later after you joined Uber. But when you join, you were forming the platform team. It sounds like that. You said democratizing, but democratizing words, not sure whether it is so often used anymore, but used to be used so often that I don't know what it means. So, like, what was the, you know, when you were hired, how you measured the success? What was the first milestone? How to start building ML platform team?
So I'll tell you. So I think a lot of things are a lot more clear when you look like, you know, back in time, you look retrospectively. At the time, it was just like we're building this thing to enable data scientists, and we didn't really have a it wasn't as obvious to us. We didn't know like how successful we could be or how much value this thing could unlock, but it was just clear that there was a lot of data scientists who were not able to get things into production. We didn't think, I have to say, we weren't thinking as much about the like theory of the data science life cycle and how ML, like MLOps wasn't a term, but like how that stuff should work. It was more like, hey, there's a bunch of problems where people should be using machine learning and they're not, so go figure it out. So we had a couple of like projects that were kind of like the first projects who were signed up to be our customers. It was three of them, and I kind of inherited those. And actually, this is a good, maybe like a good lesson for everybody. But like, you got to be careful as an ML platform team who you work with, and especially the first people you work with, because we, I think like most of the two, if not all three of those first three projects were complete failures. They were complete failures, not because the machine learning didn't work or something, but it was literally an organizational thing where one project like didn't make any sense and there shouldn't have been. It was just like a dumb project. The other project, they got reorganized or something, and so we spent a bunch of time on it, and then just it wasn't important after. And I think the third one, like I think it just didn't, the data science side of it didn't end up working out. But if I was going to choose, like today, if I was going to do it, I would have a much better appreciation for how to, or I would think a lot more closely around, like, how do I choose which internal customers I want to get as a platform team? I really care about getting like some quick wins to show off the value of the system. I also care about focusing on teams where there's actually value to the company. There's all kinds of different projects that people, you know, some companies that have all kinds of different projects, but you want to find, as the platform team, as the enabling group, the one that's actually driving the business, and focus on them quite a bit. Because
it's very interesting what you're saying. It's not intuitive, because when you're shaping platform team, their goal is help other teams, right?
So let me work with anybody. I'm looking for anybody that wants to work with me, kind of thing.
But I also saw a pattern where you are starting from those who are struggling the most, but very often the teams that are struggling the most are not struggling because it's technically problematic. Very often it's business wise problematic. That's why nobody cares. It sounds like maybe a better strategy, at least to have a balance, like to have at least semi-successful team first, as among your first internal customer when you're building ML platform team.
Yeah, and I think this is like a thing that we've gotten, you know, at Tekton, we're a platform team too, right? We sell to not internal customers, but external customers.
Platform team.
Yeah, and we have to, you know, we have to prioritize who... Like, a lot of people want to work with us, and we have to choose who we want to work with. And we think a lot about, like, is this thing actually going to matter to these people? Is this a high-value thing for this customer or not? And a variety of other, like dimensions. And I'll tell you what I did at Uber, which I thought was, I don't know, maybe somebody suggested it to me, but it ended up being pretty helpful. What I did was I just went around and I was like, I'm going to meet every single data science team in the company. And so I went and talked to every data scientist, and I made a spreadsheet where I literally said, like, I tracked what is the data science problem they're solving, and then a whole bunch of things related to it. Is this something that we can help with? Is it valuable? Does this team want us to help with it? Is this team capable of owning this project after we help them with it? Is this team sophisticated enough to work with us? Like probably a couple other things like that. And we kept learning like other questions. Like we'd want to work with somebody and then we'd be like, oh, well, this wasn't a good fit for this reason. Like, do they have data collected? You know, do they have data? That's another column.
So these three teams, the first ones. So when you built some capabilities for them, I guess, right? Did you manage to reuse whatever you built for them?
Yes. Yes. Good question. Yeah. So we were building a very generic, I think like a pretty generic system, and we, I can say we went down like the wrong path. Like I remember at some, we were able to reuse some stuff. We were not able to reuse some stuff, and it wasn't obvious at the time what fits in an ML platform. So we had to, like, I just remember one team was doing this weird algorithm thing, and I don't even recall us talking about like, hey, that's not a thing that nobody else wants. We just thought that's a thing that has to be built here. And now it's much more clear. Like, it's pretty, you know, if you work in this space, you kind of know that's what belongs in ML platform. That's what does not. And that wasn't super clear at the time. But I think we've, you know, we evolved that understanding over time.